Hold on tight, we're about to pop some bubbly. Get ready to learn about sparkling wines. Welcome back to Divino Wine School. I'm Annie Shapiro, certified sommelier and your guide on the multi-sensory adventure that is wine tasting. It is day 5, feeling alive, and things are about to get fizzy. Today we are talking all about bubbles, or effervescence as we call it. Come on. If you're excited about today, shoot me a comment like pop my cork down below in the comment section. Or just tell me what you're drinking today or your favorite sparkling wine in general. Before we get started today, as usual, I brought something to smell. In this case, yellow delicious apples and Bartlett pears. These white fruit notes show up in a lot of still white wines and sparkling wines, including the one we're drinking today. But remember, you won't recognize them in your glass if you don't recognize them in the real world. Do whatever you have to do to experience this scent, lock it in, make a memory, make an association. If you don't have any fresh pears, do you remember those clear plastic trays in elementary school where they would give you a serving of fresh fruit and vegetables? Those mushy, overripe Bartlett pears from a can are my earliest memory of the pear scent. In the last episodes, we talked about the color of the wine and what that can tell you about grape varieties, wine growing, and wine making, and what to expect on the nose and the palate when you finally get to stop looking and start tasting. I brought something bubbly today, an easy breezy Prosecco. You can use whatever you want for this lesson, or you can simply watch and listen and grab a bottle and test your skills later. But remember, you can always enroll to find out in advance what we're drinking and smelling and talking about and get a copy of the class notes. The Enroll Now link is down in the description. In the last episode, we talked about how more intense colors promise a more intense aroma and probably a more intense palate. Along with color, the wine's consistency directly corresponds to what you may smell, taste, and feel. What is consistency? Think of how you would normally use the word. I see it a lot in cooking. It refers to how liquids hold themselves together. So, viscosity, density, and texture, roughness or smoothness, and effervescence, like the wine we're drinking today. So first we looked at the color of the wine, then we look at the consistency, how it moves in the glass, and if it's bubbly, how big are the bubbles and how long do they last? Going back to science, the byproducts of alcoholic fermentation are alcohol and carbon dioxide. For still wines, the fermentation happens in an open tank. If you put a lid on it, pressure starts to build, hence sparkling wines. If you just stop there, this method is called the Charmat method, and it is used for less expensive sparkling wines like Prosecco. This process produces small to medium-sized bubbles that burst and disappear fairly quickly after you open the bottle. Give your Prosecco a good sniff if you've got it. Do you smell any apple or pear in there? These are both common scent notes for the grape Glera, which is the grape used for Prosecco. In the case of Champenoise-style wines like Champagne, Cava, Italian Metodo Classico, and Cremant, the wines are put into the bottle and enough yeast is added to restart fermentation, therefore causing more pressure to build. Higher pressure in a much smaller container causes much smaller bubbles. And when you open a bottle, these tiny bubbles crowd to the surface and disappear much more slowly as they release CO2. So when you tip your glass to the side to check out the color and consistency, check out the bubbles. How big or small are they? How long do they last? How many of them are there? Do they disappear or do they stick around for a while? Alcoholic fermentation happens when yeast feeds on sugar. So basic science tells us, the more fermentation, the less sugar remains. As a very general rule, you can expect something like Prosecco, which is lower pressure, to be a little bit sweeter and silkier than Champagne, which is extremely dry and crisp. There are plenty of exceptions to this rule, of course. That happens when winemakers add a little bit of sugar and wine back in the bottle to adjust the sweetness level. So when you are looking at your champagne or your sparkling wine and trying to figure out how sweet it will be, your nose and your palate will definitely come into play. The label often indicates how sweet or dry the wine will be. It might say off dry, brut, extra brut. But don't worry, we've got a whole lesson on sweet versus dry wines coming up, so I recommend you subscribe and enroll to stay tuned. In wines like Prosecco, with bigger bubbles that don't last quite as long, you can expect these fresh fruit notes, pears, apples, a little bit of lemon. In general, smaller, tighter bubbles that last longer indicate a longer fermentation process and more yeast. What that means, aromatically, is you should expect notes of crusty bread, toast, biscuits, nuts, and spices, which are all fermentation notes of yeast. If you don't know what those things smell like, get out there in the world and make a scent memory before you crack your next bottle. I think brunch is a great place to start. And don't forget to leave me your comments and questions in the comments section down below. I look forward to seeing you again next Thursday. Cheers!